Federal District Court has granted summary judgment to the USDA that could reinstate country of origin labeling for ranchers and the beef that they raise. Russell Nemitz tells us more in our Montana Ag Network feature.
Well, now that we have a court-established finding that lack of country of origin labeling harms cattle producers in the United States, we're going directly to the White House.
In a lawsuit filed by RCAF USA, the organization alleged that the USDA was unlawfully allowing imported beef to be sold to consumers without a country of origin label and sold to consumers with a product of USA label, even if the animal from which the beef was derived was born, raised, and processed in a foreign country. RCAF USA CEO Bill Bullard says the court's finding is very important.
The federal district court found that the statute of limitations had expired to consider the merits of our country of origin labeling lawsuit. But very importantly, the court found that despite what USDA has said and despite what the meatpacking lobby has said, U.S. cattle producers were harmed when country of origin labeling was repealed, and that harm is fairly traceable to the USDA's actions in repealing country of origin labeling. So that clearly establishes what we've said all along, and that is country of origin labeling is beneficial to U.S. cattle producers, and the loss of that labeling will financially harm them, and the court agreed with us.
He says this is why it's even more clear that the Trump administration must act now.
President Trump has initiated a Buy American, Hire American program, and country of origin labeling fits right in. In fact, we've told the White House that unless we have labels that clearly distinguishes the U.S. product, U.S. consumers cannot choose to buy American, which is what we need to help rebuild our economy and help rebuild the middle class. So we're focusing right now on the White House. We have provided the White House with a lot of information about country of origin labeling. We know they're looking at it, and we're hopeful that they will initiate action to reinstate country of origin labeling very soon.
Ranchers like Scott Frazier from Reed Point, Montana, agree that country of origin labeling is important for them and consumers.
The thing I like about it is it lets the consumer know that the beef that they're eating is born, raised, and slaughtered in America.
As for the future of country of origin labeling, RCAF USA says it's asking President Trump to immediately reinstate COOL, either through an executive order or through his ongoing renegotiation of NAFTA. In Billings, Russell Nemitz, MTN News.
Opponents of country of origin labeling argue that the regulation would mean costly tracking and labeling, potentially retaliatory tariffs, and a signal to our trading partners that the U.S. is not willing to abide by international trade decisions.